Hey everyone, I'm Kate and I'm joined here with Elly. We both work at Wealthfront and are generally just really passionate about personal finance. So we've teamed up today to talk to you about a topic that we both have personally just gone through, how to handle finances with your significant other or your partner. And so we are both newly married, and so Elly and I are gonna go through kind of the ins and outs of that first initial conversation with your partner about money, all the way through tying the knot and thinking about combining finances. So, Elly, let's start from the very beginning. Do you remember when the first time you and your husband, Pat, first talked about finances was? Give us a scoop there.
Yeah, sure. So, yeah, it kind of came up naturally. There wasn't like one conversation that I specifically remember, but we started dating around the time that I was just like naturally starting to learn more about finances. I was like learning what maxing out a 401k is like and what a Roth or traditional IRA is. And so I was just like learning these things and sharing with him like, oh, I learned about this thing like right. that you should do to save for retirement. Like, wow. And so we became kind of like savings partners in that. Like, he liked having those conversations too, which was really cool. So I'd like share an article and be like, wow, did you know you should like try to save this much per month? And he'd be like, oh, okay. And so that was kind of like the start of it. But then we decided to move in pretty early. So we moved in at 6 months.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And then we also bought a car at that time.
Just went for it.
And so those were like big financial decisions, you know. How much can we spend on rent? How much can we spend on a car? Buying furniture is really expensive, yep. turns out. So all that stuff, that made us have like the more nitty gritty conversations around like, okay, how much do we actually make? How much do we feel comfortable spending every month? Stuff like that. And what about you and Nate? How did it first come up for you guys?
Yes, well, ours also came up pretty early on in our relationship, and I'm not sure if that's, you know, a function of the fact that we started dating in our mid-30s, or I'm just, you know, kind of a weirdo when it comes to obsessing over personal finance. So,
smart about.
Yeah, you know, just, you need to talk about these
yeah.
things. So, you know, I think really early on, I just wanted to make sure that I was contributing enough financially to our relationship. And, you know, he was like picking up a lot of tabs, and I just didn't want him to feel that he had to do that.
Yeah.
So one night over martinis, I just awkwardly, you know, asked him, how much money do you make? So I think he was a little taken aback by that. But it really led, you know, once the initial awkwardness was over, it really led to actually a good discussion around money, what we're saving, what are our goals, you know, kind of. Even just beyond money, I think it really opened the door to having a conversation about like what we want out of life.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think, you know, it can be a little bit uncomfortable, a little bit awkward, but I'm really happy that we did have that conversation early on, because I think it just led to like a really fruitful alignment of like what
yeah.
we were both trying to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's our story, but yeah, exactly. So you've been married for several months now. Congratulations.
Mm.
Yeah.
You too.
I know. Thank you. So has anything changed from like that first conversation and how you guys first operate to, you know, now that you've been married for,
yeah.
for a few months?
Yeah. Yeah. So when we first started dating, like I did not want money to be stressful at all. So we came up with a system that I really liked. And so we just split everything 50-50. But then we prorated the rent based on our salary. But then we would put everything in splitwise and then pay each other at the end of the month. So it was like
I've never heard of a splitwise use like that. I
yes,
love it.
Yes. It was kind of, I guess, like clinical, but also made it feel
yep.
really fair because, like, we just knew, like, I'm putting in stuff he's putting in, and we just know it's fair at the end of the month. So that was really, I really liked that.
Yeah.
And then we got a joint credit card when we moved in together because there were, like, big purchases. We wanted to get points, and we wanted to, like, share
Smart.
The points. But we still kept separate checking accounts, and we still, like, did the Splitwise stuff. But once we got engaged, that's when that kind of, like, the Splitwise just stopped being attended to as much. There weren't as many Venmos going back and forth. And then, yeah, when we got married, that just kind of ended. And I thought we weren't going to combine, But then recently it's been kind of like, oh, how much are we spending?
Yeah.
How much are we saving? I found it pretty hard to know without having that like one pool where everything's going in and everything's going out. So even though it feels like kind of administratively annoying, I think we will actually end up combining.
Oh, wow. Though. Okay. Yeah. That's a change, I think, of heart, right?
Yeah. Yeah. But I think you do this. I will keep my own card because I don't know. I also like to know how much I'm spending on myself. Like, he has his stuff. He loves golf. And, like, I love going out to drinks.
Right.
And I love shopping. And I just like to know how much, you know, how much I'm doing on those personal things.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah. What about you guys? What has anything changed now that you're newlyweds?
Not yet. So we have not combined anything. I think what we actually came up with, actually pretty early on after that first conversation we had, was sort of this like prorated system based on how much we both make. And so that's worked pretty well. So like big ticket items, we'll basically use this like prorated split system. And then in terms of like individual, like not individual expenses, but expenses that are both for us collectively, we own certain things. So I'll basically cover groceries, all things that are kind of like inside of the home. And then Nate will cover kind of dinners out, things like that, that we do out of the home together. I will say that I too am a fan of having my own Amex. I do not need Nate to see how much I spend on my skincare or my shoes. Less shoes now, you know, in 2021, but skincare I will not skimp on. So definitely don't need him seeing that. And I think it is good to know like what you are actually spending solo as well.
Yeah.
So you can still feel really involved in your finances and have a handle on that. I do think though, after getting married and, you know, we just bought a home together and things like that, the finances are definitely becoming really convoluted. Mm-hmm. So we'll see if we keep this separate system. I think we'll probably keep it for a while longer because we're both super lazy. And as you said, it's sort of an administrative task to combine. So we'll see how it works and maybe we'll do a follow-up on that.
And what about like longer term goals? How do you guys think about saving for those together? I know you just bought a house. But
yes.
You know,
yeah. So buying a house was interesting because it was something that we had actually both been separately saving for, but it was our first very big combined purchase. So it was fun. That was, again, another forcing function, I think, to just kind of look at all of our accounts collectively and see, you know, what's realistic combined. So we actually bought a home before we got married. We were newly engaged, actually. But so that's been a big one that we were both saving for independently, but just kind of, you know, pulled the trigger on that. And so I think right now, in terms of just long-term collective goals, the number one priority for us right now is like refilling that cash that just went out the door. It's like so jarring just to see how much money goes into a down payment. So we are just very, very focused on spending less right now and just saving, just kind of refilling the emergency savings and things like that. So we don't really have any kind of like specific moment in time goals. I think the other thing that's kind of on the horizon is just thinking about kids and making sure that we have, you know, everything in order to prepare for that. So yeah. What about you guys? What's on deck for you?
Yeah, we're in like kind of the no strong goals. I mean, we would like to think about buying a house. We're not sure about kids, but like don't want finances to prevent that.
Yes,
so
we're
kind of like in the save as much as possible phase. And then like, you know, if we want to buy a home in like 2 years, that we would be ready. So that's kind of where we're at, though we don't have like a specific, like this date we want to do this or this one we want to do that. And then we're definitely also like really big on saving for retirement. Like Pat would really like to retire early.
Oh, Nate too.
So I think we're, you know, it's kind of just like as much as possible spending, you know, trying not to spend too much.
Yes.
Investing as much, maxing out the things as much as possible. And then that way, like, if we do see a house that we're really excited about, that we would be ready instead of having to be like, oh shoot, like we still have to wait.
Yeah, that's the thing. I think, and that's again why it's just so good to be on the same page, because I think you want to make sure that A, you're both kind of looking for the same opportunities financially, and you have the means to kind of jump on them when they do present themselves, yeah. right? You know, like, for example, Nate and I, you know, we wanted to buy a home at some point, but we didn't really have a date or mm-hmm. a deadline on it. And, you know, the real estate market has just been so hot lately. Interest rates are super low. Yeah. And so we kind of last minute decided that it was the right time. Mm. And so if we mm-hmm. hadn't been saving for that, you know, we wouldn't have been able to do that.
Yeah.
And so I think it's just really important that you guys are aligned. It's like, okay, maybe you don't have a date.
Right.
But you know you want to achieve this at some point.
Yeah.
So, and then, yeah, Nate definitely would like to retire early as well. So I'm working hard for him to do that.
Making sure he can really hit that goal.
Exactly. Really just making sure he gets there
Such
quickly.
A good partner.
Yes, I try. I try my best. Any final thoughts, any tips that you would give folks just when kind of approaching the conversation or thinking through all these things with your partner?
Yeah, I feel like what I found is, like, money is obviously really daunting, especially if you, like, don't work in it, don't think about it,
right.
don't like to read about it. But, like, I found that when I started to try to learn about it, like, making it a conversation and kind of, like, trying to learn together really helped, because then it was like, I'm confused, like, let's talk about this,
yeah.
or, like, what have you heard about this? And making it kind of like a joint learning activity,
yeah,
instead of
that.
Like, oh, we have to do this, but it's very stressful and we don't know how, making it like more like that.
Yeah. Absolutely. And I think, yeah, I think the last thing that I would just leave on is just have the conversation.
Yes.
Because, you know, I think it was just such an important foundation for our relationship and really helped us align early on. And it just removes that one thing as a stress, you know?
Yeah.
So I think that would just be the note that I would end on.
Yeah.
But thank you everyone so much for listening. Ellie and I will be back to go through more topics. We just want to be able to help you all go through these conversations and feel empowered to tackle them the right way. So thanks for listening, and we'll hopefully see you soon.